A blog is an online journal or informational website. The information it displays is the latest news or facts for a certain time. A blog's purpose is to give an audience a fresh view of the content with as much credibility as possible. These blogs can include images or charts to add visual content to grab more of the reader's attention. The word itself comes from the term weblog, which was coined by John Barger on December 17, 1977, and the short-term blog was coined by Peter Merholz in May of 1999. A vlog with a V stands for a video blog and is a personal website or social media account where a person regularly posts short videos. The term blog was coined by Luke Bowman in 2002 when he began to make a video diary of his post-college travels. He called it a vlog because the videos were originally named video logs or blogs. However, the first vlogger and the longest active vlogger as of 2019 is Adam Contras, who is really seen as the creator of vlogging. It is now used for social media influencers on YouTube to protect their lives and entertain their audience with crazy or funny content.
Hey, so between the years of 2007 and 2014, the total weekday circulation of US daily newspapers has dropped from about 50 million to about 40 million. The print industry took its first big hit in the 50s when the television really came about, and they took its first major circulation hit in the 90s when the internet blew up because everyone was just getting their news sources online, so there wasn't much need for print news. But many local newspapers do still remain. Like I know the one from my area, the Clifton Park newspaper, and then other newspapers like the Post Standard and the Sullivan County Democrat still do remain.
Blogging is a new way for people to search any news stated on cable news. Rather than sitting through and watching the news, people can read summaries and save so much of their time. An example of one blog that is used for the news is BuzzFeed. BuzzFeed publishes new information within about 5 hours or of the same day. Around 12 p.m., Taylor Swift posted that her new recorded song was released, and I didn't know that until BuzzFeed posted it. The credibility of these blogs are determined by their sources of evidence provided. For the Taylor Swift song, the proof was on Instagram, where she stated the information herself. Another effect blogging has on cable news is the 24/7 service it provides. People have constant access to the news, channels, and websites through blogging to know what is happening around them, such as Amber Alerts. People are notified when someone is missing, and people get notifications in order to look out for the missing person. According to statistics, Fox News is the most watched news channel. Other major news networks are CNN and MSNBC.
Facebook is the largest social network in the world. People who want to learn knowledge about certain things often turn to Facebook pages or groups for their discussions. Facebook now has groups for your online class for online learning. A professor can make a page for their students where their course is then delivered. Facebook also has a design option to allow professors to provide efficient and organized information. Another common social media platform that is used is YouTube. Many online educators provide their students with links to review course material through another educator. YouTube allows sharing and pinning to allow the video to be saved and dispersed easily amongst others. For filter bubbles, use of social media or even Google can allow people to search topics of interest. Pinterest is the most common used search engine to learn from for interest on certain things. Pinterest is a great visual discovery for things like recipes, home decorating, and even fashion advice. This filter bubble is used for a ton of people to learn new things about something they have no experience with. The problem with learning from social media and filter bubbles is the credibility of it. On social media, influencers use the theory of persuasion and use of personal opinions to get their point across. With filter bubbles, someone can recommend a face mask or a product to try, saying it 100% works when it actually doesn't. This occurs with small businesses seeking money rather than satisfaction of their product.